The inquiry into the controversial sale of the Uganda Railway properties continued today with members of the Committee on Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, quizzing officials of the privatization unit. The committee tasked the privatization unit, which sold part of the land, to explain why some properties were sold off without advertising them to potential bidders.
What was the basis of selling, even coming up with the idea? You may have the powers. You may even, for you to talk of selling public assets, whether core or non-core, because, you know, URC was undergoing a process which required no funds at the time. Even when you sold, maybe you did not meet its obligations and liabilities. So what was the basis for you to sell?
There's TPDA regulations which we must follow. This is government property. And so we advertise. And you advertised. However, there are properties that were not advertised because sitting tenants were going to be given the first option.
Yes.
Under what law?
Our perusal of the record shows that some properties were not included in the advert because they were for sitting tenants. So the policy was to give sitting tenants the first right to acquire the assets. So the ones that were advertised were ones where there were no sitting tenants. We're going to peruse the record some more so that we can provide information that backs up that explanation.
Hell broke loose when MPs put privatization unit officials on spot to explain how several prime properties were sold to few individuals who happened to be big shots in government, including Robert Mwesigwa, the Mbarara Division North MP, who obtained 4 properties out of 15, and General David Sejusa.
You find the same names and people who are connected. When you say connected persons, I think is now clear. It is a legally adopted word. Connected persons, you find army officers, and members of parliament, etc. So beyond beating the reserve price, this committee is also concerned that the properties were sold to one or two individuals.
Were there no multiple bidders? And if so, how did you arrive at him as opposed to him to buy the land?
First of all, the answer is yes. There were multiple bidders on all the properties they were highly competed for. And I think in our response, we can even show the exact people who bid. That information is available. We can show who they are, what the price was, and of course, there was a valuation exercise which determined the best bidder.
The privatization unit officials labored to explain why the Uganda Railway Corporation has taken over 10 years without receiving its proceeds amounting 69 billion shillings accumulated from the sale of its Nsambya land, which government has allocated to private investors. Mwasi told the committee that their efforts to pursue the money from the Ministry of Finance have ended in futility.
Worth 69.5 billion, as have been valued, was sold. Where is this money? Because we asked URC, the owner of the land, and they say they don't know where this money is. In your explanation at the start, you said this property, it was determined that it be sold so that URC can be buttressed.
We had written several times and requested that the money be availed, that the money be paid to URC, but this never happened.